Welcome to Name of Jesus Sunday, January 1st, 2023. Happy New Year to all. We look back on the past and the challenges, and even the joys. We look back, but now we look to the future and we look to hope. And this is a great time to look at the name of Jesus, because through Jesus, that is our source of hope. From the beginning through baptism, we're called Christian. We're christened at the font. Bearing Christ's name, we share the same Father and invited to address this parent intimately. Abba! Jesus bears our sin in humble obedience to the will of God. Today we pray the mind of Christ, whose name we bear, would be our own, is a good way to begin another year. The Holy Spirit called us together as the people of God. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, whose steadfast love endures forever. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Amen. Most merciful God, God of life, you promise good news of great joy for all people and call us to be messengers of your peace. We confess that we too often hoard our joy, our resources, and our security. We nurture conflict and build barriers. We neglect the needs of our neighbors and ignore the grooming of creation. Have mercy on us, for we are self-centered. Open our hearts, where we are reluctant. Give us courage, where we are cynical. Restore our trust. Renew us with your grace and give us again the hope of eternal life in you. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us. And for his sake, God forgives you all your sins. As a called and ordained minister in the Church of Christ, and by his authority, therefore declare to you to forgive us all your sins. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Jesus Christ is risen today. Triumphant holy day, alleluia. Who did once upon the cross, alleluia, suffer to redeem our loss, alleluia. Hymns of praise and let us sing, Christ, our heavenly King, alleluia. Who endured the cross and grave, alleluia. Sinners to redeem and save, alleluia. But the pains which he endured, salvation have procured, alleluia. Now above the sky he's King, alleluia, where the angels ever sing, alleluia. Sing we turn to our God.
Now the Kyrie. Listen, as God speaks to us in scripture, preaching, and song.
The first reading this morning is from The book of Numbers, chapter 6, verses 22 to 27. God commanded Aaron to say these words, known as the Aaronic benediction, in blessing the people of Israel. We too are marked with God's name and God's blessing as we are sent from our assemblies into the world. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, thus you shall bless the Israelites. You shall say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. So they shall put my name on the Israelites, and I will bless them. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Let's share Psalm 8 responsibly. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth.
You whose glory is chanted above the heavens, out of the mouths of infants and children,
you have set up a fortress against your enemies, to silence the foe and avenger. When I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars you have set in their courses, what are your mortals that you should be mindful of them? Human beings that you should care for them. You have, yet you have made them little less than divine. With glory and honor you crown them.
You have made them rule over the works of your hands. You have put all things under their feet,
all flocks and cattle, even the wild beasts of the field,
the birds of the air, the fish of the sea, and whatever passes along the paths of the sea.
O Lord our God, how majestic is your name in all the earth. The second reading is found in Galatians chapter 4. Paul proclaims the ultimate significance of the Nativity. Jesus was born, the Son of God, so that because of him, we all may be God's children. When the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, in order to redeem those who were under the law, so that we might receive adoption as children. And because you are children, God has sent his Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a child. And if a child, then also an heir through God. Word of God. Word of life.
Thanks be to God. Today's Holy Gospel is the book of St. Luke, the second chapter, verses 15 to 21. Glory to you, O Lord. 8 days after his birth, Jesus is circumcised according to Jewish law and given the name announced by the angel before his conception. When the angels had left and gone to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, let us go now to Bethlehem and see the things that have taken place, which the Lord has made known to us. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child laying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child. He was called Jesus, the name given by the angel, before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Grace and peace from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Happy New Year. January 1st, this New Year's Day, it is the eighth day of Christmas. Our Christian New Year resolution is to begin the year praising the name of Jesus Christ and receiving God's blessing. That's why this is Name of Jesus Sunday. What we see, come, and hear today is a commemoration of the name of Jesus, which invites us to begin the new year under the power of Christ's name. On the first day of the year, we too adore Christ, whose name means the Lord saves. This year we affirm the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior And because of our belief in him, we are part of the family. We are heirs to the kingdom. Through our baptism, we have hope because we became heirs to God's kingdom when we joined in his death and will join in his resurrection. This gives us the name of Christian. We realize we all fall short of the glory of God. So every day as we wake, we can pray and confess our shortcomings, which gives us hope as every day is a new creation. In the Freedom of the Christian, Martin Luther wrote in 1520, as our Heavenly Father has in Christ freely come to our aid, we also ought freely to help neighbors through our body and its works, and each one should become as it were a Christ to the other, that we may be Christ to one another, and Christ may be the same in all. That is, that we may truly be Christians. And of course, he quotes Ephesians 2:8-10, which meant so much to him. For by grace you've been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. So what Luther says about good works, because of what God has done for us, we have freedom to help others. And that's not our way to salvation, is through good works, but rather to serve others. As we are slave to all, but slave to none. In Mere Christianity, C.S. Lewis several times used the term, little Christ. Of the purpose of the church, Lewis said, is to exist for nothing else but to draw men into Christ, to make them little Christ. If they are not doing that, all the cathedrals, the clergy, missions, sermons, even the Bible itself are simply a waste of time. God became man for no other person. So think of the time you spent with Jesus and dealing with Jesus. It's interesting because Mark Locato in Everyday Blessings says, imagine considering every moment as a potential time of communion with God. By the time your life is over, you will have spent 6 months at stoplights, 8 months opening junk mail, a year and a half looking for lost stuff, and a whopping 5 years standing in various lines. Why don't you give those moments to God? So as Christians, we are always in communion with Christ. Just look at what happens when the shepherds arise. They hurry to see him. It's like young children on a Christmas morning hurrying to the tree to see what is there. They arrive to see the baby Jesus as the angel had described. They find Mary and Joseph, who each also had their encounter with an angel, adoring their new son in a manger wrapped in cloths. Bands of cloth, just as the angel had told them. These are proud parents, most likely tired parents. You remember those days with newborn? And this is a traditional family, yet a divine and holy family that's been chosen by God. The shepherds, the angel, told them, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. So how does this teenage mother of a newborn child respond to this? I love the song, Mary, Do You Know? Mary, Did You Know? The closing lyrics are, Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Mary, did you know your baby boy would one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfectly lamb? That sleeping child you're holding is the great I Am. Well, everybody's amazed, but Mary treasured these words from the shepherds. And he reinforces what you've been told before, which is obedient to God and agreed to carry God's child. It was from Luke 1:30-32. The angel said to her, do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you'll conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you'll name him Jesus. He'll be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. Mary treasures the words of the shepherds, which reinforce what she told, before when she was obedient to God and agreed to carry this child. But how does Mary wrap her heart around this, or her head around this, as she ponders it in her heart? So yes, we're on the eighth day of Christmas, eight of the 12 days, and many have spent time with family. We ponder our hearts, our own definition of family and belonging. At our baptism, we become children of God and are called Christians. We believe in Christ and humbly share our affiliation with other children of God as the Holy Spirit gathers together, where we come to love and support one another and be humble and graceful to one another and celebrate our God-given diversity and beauty. Everyone is welcome into our family as we hear about God through scripture, preaching, and song, and we go out in the world to share Christ in going and telling, serving, inviting. We share the gospel with others and use words where necessary with the mind and heart of Christ. Today we celebrate our blessing and the power of calling God by name, as well as how deeply we know God and are known by God through Jesus. Jesus, by his name and his very being, was known and loved well before he was conceived, born, and joined the traditional entry into the community. The heir of God, the adopted son, was known and loved deeply and given a mission and purpose in the world. We are also the heirs of God's mysteries, and as adopted children, we are named, commissioned, and blessed, not because of our lineage, our ancestry, our family affiliation, but because of God's love for us as we carry out God's mission in the world. God's work on our hands. Through the infant Christ, we can see and know ourselves to be part of the family of God for which we and all people have been chosen. And that's very good news indeed. That we say.
And freedom and justice, truth, and love. So let your praise be sounding, for kindness so abounding. Hosanna to the Lord, for he fulfills God's word.
Now we share our faith in the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, St. Nancy. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made of one being, with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended to heaven and seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now for the prayers of the church.
With wonder and thanksgiving for Christ coming into the world, we pray for the church, the life of the earth, and the whole human family. Holy God, you have given the church the holy name of Jesus, and in him we are your beloved children. Unite us in mission through the power of his Spirit. Make us worthy of the name we bear, the name in which we pray. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Renewing God, restore your glory to the earth. Awaken humanity to our kinship with all living things that depend on your provision. Teach us to care for the earth and safeguard its treasures for those who come after us. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Peacemaking God, reconcile the nations, leading those in conflict into negotiations, especially in areas of religious or ethnic strife. End acts of aggression and violence carried out in your name. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Send angels to protect, to provide care and compassion to those who serve in our armed forces as they face the trauma of war. We pray especially for Beth and Ryan, Cohen, Jonathan, Jacob, Noah, Irene, and Alex. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Delivering God, rescue our siblings in any danger, especially in communities where disaster and disease threaten. Move those in authority to respond with speed and compassion. We pray for the safety of first responders, healthcare workers, and all who protect us. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Healing God, raise up any who are bowed down with illness or sorrow. Deepen our care and our concern for one another. We lift to you all who are undergoing transition in relationships, occupation, living situations, or health conditions, especially those we name silently in our hearts. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
We especially lift up to you Presiding Bishop Elizabeth, our Synod Bishop Craig, and Pastor Carl. We ask that you be with their respective staffs as they live out their callings to serve. As we are called to be one, even as Jesus and the Father are one, be with the leaders and the congregation of Lebanon Lutheran Church, Whitehall. Hear us, O God.
Hear our prayer.
Saving God, redeem us and grant us eternal peace. We give thanks for the faithful departed who now rest in your undying love, made known to us in Jesus our Emmanuel. God of grace, hear our prayer.
Honor the mystery of her eternal love made flesh in Christ Jesus. We commend all for whom we pray to the mercy of God. Now, my friends, God blesses us this new year and every day, wishes to send us into mission into the world. God bless you and keep you. Jesus grant you peace and grace and truth and spirit send peace upon your hearts now and forever.
Go in peace, proclaim the good news.
Thanks be to God.